जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंदा जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद हरये नमः कृष्ण यादवाय नमः गोपाल गोविंद राम श्री मधुसूदन हरये नमः कृष्ण यादवाय नमः गोपाल गोविंद राम श्री मधुसूदन हरये नमः कृष्ण यादवाय नमः गोपाल गोविंद राम श्री मधुसूदन हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जहाँ विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर सत्य श्री श्रीमद हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस श्री भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जाय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जाय नामाचार्य हरिदास ठाकुर की जाय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद की जाय श्री श्री राधा कृष्णा गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंद राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जाय वृंदावन धाम की जाय नवदीप धाम की जाय भक्ति देवी की जाय तुलसी महारानी की जाय यमुना देवी की जाय गंगा देवी की जाय समवेता भक्त वृंद की जाय गौर प्रेमानंदे ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असम डिवोटीज All glories to the Assemble devotees. All glories to the Assemble devotees. All glories to Sri Sri Guru and Gauranga. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamaniti Namani Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pacharani Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tarani. We are hearing the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, which is also translated as the character of the living force in immortality. We are studying the Adi Lila, chapter number 3, the external reasons for the appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we left off on text number 30, is that correct? What's that? Thank you. Chaitanya Singhera Navadvipe Avatar Singha Griva Singha Virya Singhera Hunkar. Thus, the lion-like Lord Chaitanya has appeared in Navadvip. He has the shoulders of a lion, the powers of a lion, and the loud voice of a lion. Se Singha Vasuk Jivar Hridaya Kandare Kalmashat Dviradi Nashe Jahara Hunkare. May that lion be seated in the core of the heart of every living being. Thus, with his resounding roar, may he drive away one's elephantine vices. Pratama Lilaya Tar Vishvambaranam Bhakti Rase Bharila Dharila Bhutagram. In his early pastimes, He is known as Vishvambara. Everybody say. Vishvambara. Because he floods the world with the nectar of devotion and thus saves the living beings. Dubrindatura artha poshana dharan. Pushila dharila prema diya tribhuvan. The verbal root dubrin, which is the root of the word Vishvambara, indicates nourishing and maintaining. He, Lord Chaitanya, nourishes and maintains the three worlds by distributing love of God. Shesha Lilaya Dhare Nam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sri Krishna Janaye Sabha Vishva Koila Danya. In his later pastimes, he is known as Lord Sri Krishna Chaitanya. He blesses the whole world by teaching about the name and fame of Lord Sri Krishna. Purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Lord Chaitanya remained a householder only until his 24th year had passed. Then he entered the renounced order and remained manifest in this material world until his 48th year. Therefore, his Shesha Lila, or the final portion of his activities, lasted 24 years. Some so-called Vaishnavas say that the renounced order of life was not accepted in the Vaishnava Sampradaya or disciplic succession until Lord Chaitanya. This is not a very intelligent proposition. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the sannyas order from Sripad Keshava Bharati, who belonged to the Shankara sect, which approves of only 10 names for sannyasis. Long before the advent of Sripad Shankaracharya, however, the sannyas order existed in the Vaishnava line of Vishnu Swami. In the Vishnu Swami Vaishnava Sampradaya, there are 10 different kinds of sannyas names and 108 different names for sannyasis who accept the Tridanda, the triple staff of sannyas. This is approved by the Vedic rules. Therefore, Vaishnava sannyas was existent even before the appearance of Shankaracharya. Although those who know nothing about Vaishnava sannyas unnecessarily declare that there is no sannyas in the Vaishnava Sampradaya. During the time of Lord Chaitanya, the influence of Shankaracharya in society was very strong. People thought that one could accept sannyas only in the disciplic succession of Shankaracharya. Lord Chaitanya could have performed his missionary activities as a householder, but he found householder life an obstruction to his mission. Therefore, he decided to accept the renounced order, sannyas. Since his acceptance of sannyas was also designed to attract public attention, Lord Chaitanya, not wishing to disturb the social convention, took the renounced order of life from a sannyasi in the disciplic succession of Shankaracharya, although sannyas was also sanctioned in the Vaishnava Sampradaya. So, in reading further along in the 7th chapter of the Adi Lila, we get more details why Lord Chaitanya took sannyas. And it is explained that there were different classes of society who was not drowning in the ocean of love of God that Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda and his associates were doing in Navadvip. So the upper classes were somehow or other escaping Lord Chaitanya's loving network. And in particular, the Mayavadi sannyasis were criticizing and blaspheming Because in the Mayavad Sampradaya, they think that bhakti, devotional service, is karma kanda, or fruitive activity. Therefore, they frown. And they think that Vaishnavas, and they even criticize Lord Chaitanya, oh, he's a sentimentalist, which is not a very nice thing to say about somebody who is supposedly very spiritually advanced. You don't call someone like that a sentimentalist. It's actually blasphemy. So when Lord Chaitanya was in Benares, he was approached by two devotees, Chandrasekhar and Tapan Mishra. And they were explaining to Lord Chaitanya that we can't tolerate all this blasphemy of your holiness, because that's what the Mayavadis were doing. They were criticizing Lord Chaitanya. Because the Mayavadis, they only have two spiritual activities. We as devotees, we have 9 different, actually 64 items of devotional service. But we have 9, hearing, chanting, remembering, praying, etc., the 9 processes. But in Shankaracharya Sampradaya, you just get 2, meditation and study Vedanta Sutra. That's it. First of all, you can't be a householder. If you're a householder, forget about it. No spiritual advancement. First take sannyas, then we can talk about spiritual advancement. That's the Shankara Sampradaya. Okay? And Shankaracharya taught, you eat pokita pokenya. You eat no chapan bhog, no big feast like we do. Huh? Lord Chaitanya's program was what? Chanting, dancing, feasting. Not in Shankaracharya. Baba, you eat this much. And you have your loincloth. You have your danda. You meditate. How do you meditate? I am God. I am Narayan. They address each other. Om Namo Narayan. We say Hari Bol, Hare Krishna. But they read each other. Om Namo Narayan. Because they think, oh, you have taken sannyas, you have become Narayan. How glorious you are. So that's how they see each other. When you take sannyas, you become God. What a process, huh? So, in the time of Lord, when he was in Navadvip, these Mayavadis were escaping Lord Chaitanya's loving network. So Lord Chaitanya was considering, how am I going to attract these blasphemers, these Mayavadi sannyasis? So Lord Chaitanya thought, since the sannyas order is so much respected in society, because it was, in the Hindu community, if you took sannyas, you were given so much respect by everybody. So Lord Chaitanya said, I will take sannyas, and they will automatically have to pay their respects and obeisances because I've taken sannyas. And by their offering obeisances, they will become free from their offenses. And once you're free from offenses, then you can chant Krishna's holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Because there's that incident when this Brahmin went to Lord Chaitanya and he said, my Lord, I mentioned you in front of Prakashananda Saraswati. He was the leader of all the all the Mayavadi sannyasis in Benares. He had, I think Prabhupada says, 60,000 sannyas disciples. So this Brahmin mentioned Lord Chaitanya, and Prakashananda, when he heard this Brahmin mention Lord Chaitanya, he said, oh yes, I know about this Chaitanya. He did not say his full name, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, because that was his name. Sri Krishna, he did not. He just said Chaitanya. And then, of course, immediately criticized, said he was a sentimentalist, and he was associating with the low-class people, blaspheming Lord Chaitanya. So this Brahmana said, my Lord, how come he couldn't say your name? He said Chaitanya, Atma, Brahma, but he could not say your name, Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya said, yes, Mayavadis are the greatest offenders. And because they offend Krishna's lotus feet, the name Krishna cannot come on their tongue. So if you're able to chant Hare Krishna, you must be doing okay. Let's all chant. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. So he took sannyas as a tactic, as a way to get everybody to begin their Krishna consciousness. It was a trick of Lord Chaitanya. Okay, back to the purport. In the Shankara Sampradaya, there are 10 different names awarded to sannyasis: Tirtha, Asram, Vana, Aranya, Giri, Parvat, Sagara, Sarasvati, Bharati, and Puri. Before one enters sannyas, he has one of the various names for a brahmachari, the assistant to a sannyasi. Sannyasis with the titles of Tirtha and Asram generally stay at Dwaraka, and their brahmachari name is Swarup. Those known by the names Vana and Aranya stay at Purushottam or Jagannath Puri, and their brahmachari name is Prakash. Those with the names Giri, Parvat, and Sagara generally stay at Badarik Ashram, and their brahmachari name is Ananda. Those with the titles Sarasvati, Bharati, and Puri usually live at Sringeri in South India, and their brahmachari name is Chaitanya. Sripad Shankaracharya established 4 monasteries in India in the 4 directions, north, south, east, and west, and he entrusted them to 4 sannyasis who were his disciples. Now there are hundreds of branch monasteries under those 4 principal monasteries, and although there is an official symmetry among them, there are many differences in their dealings. The 4 different sects of those monasteries are known as Anandavara, Bhogavara, Kitavara, and Bhumivara. And in course of time, they have developed different ideas and different slogans. Pray that that does not happen to ISKCON. May we always stay united under Srila Prabhupada and not branch out into so many different sects. According to the regulation of the disciplic succession, one who wishes to enter the renounced order in Shankara's sect must first be trained as a brahmachari under a bona fide sannyasi. The brahmachari's name is ascertained according to the group to which the sannyasi belongs. Lord Chaitanya accepted sannyas from Keshava Bharati. When he first approached Keshava Bharati, he was accepted as a brahmachari with the name Sri Krishna Chaitanya Brahmachari. After he took sannyas, he preferred to keep the name Krishna Chaitanya. Of course, that is in line with Lord Chaitanya's 3rd Shikshastakam, to always remain meek and humble. The great authorities in the disciplic succession had not offered to explain why Lord Chaitanya refused to take the name Bharati after he took sannyas from a Bharati until Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj volunteered the explanation that because a sannyasi in the Shankara Sampradaya thinks he has become the supreme, Lord Chaitanya, wanting to avoid such a misconception, kept the name Sri Krishna Chaitanya, placing himself as an eternal servitor. A brahmachari is supposed to serve the spiritual master. Therefore, he did not negate that relationship of servitude to a spiritual master. Accepting such a position is favorable for the relationship between the disciple and the spiritual master. The authentic biographies also mention that Lord Chaitanya accepted the danda, rod, and begging pot, symbolic of the sannyas order, at the time he took sannyas. Tara Yugavatara Jani Garga Mahashai Krishnara Nama Karani Kariyache Nirnai. Knowing him, Lord Chaitanya, to be the incarnation for Kali Yuga, Garga Muni, during the name-giving ceremony of Krishna, predicted his appearance. Asanvarna Strayo Hiyasya Gurunato Nu Yugam Tanu Shuklo Raktastata Pita Idanim Krishna Tam Gata. This boy, Krishna, has three colors, white, red, and yellow, as he appears in different ages. Now he has appeared in a transcendental blackish color. This verse is from Srimad Bhagavatam 10.8.13. Shukla Rakta Pita Varna 18 at Yuti Satya Treta Kalikale Dharena Sripati. White, red, and yellow, these are the three bodily lusters that the Lord, the husband of the goddess of fortune, assumes in the ages of Satya, Treta, and Kali, respectively. Idanim Dwapara 18 Ho Hoila Krishna Varna E Shava Shastra Gama Puranera Marma. Now in the Dwarapa Yuga, the Lord has descended in a blackish hue. This is the essence of the statements in the Puranas and other Vedic literatures with reference to the context. Dwapare Bhagavan Syama Pita Vasa Nayudyada Sri Vatsadibir Ankeshya Lakshanair Upalakshita. In the Dwarapa Yuga, the personality of Godhead appears in a blackish hue. He is dressed in yellow. He holds his own weapons and he is decorated with the Kaustubha jewel and marks of Sri Vatsa. This is how his symptoms are described. Purport. This is a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.27 spoken by Saint Kaurabhaj, one of the nine royal mystics who explained to King Nimi the different features of the Lord in different ages. Kali Yuga Yuga Dharma Namera Prachara Tati Lagi Pita Varna Chaitanya Avatar. The religious practice for the age of Kali is to broadcast the glories of the holy name. Only for this purpose has the Lord in a yellow color, descended as Lord Chaitanya. Purport, in this age of Kali, the practical system of religion for everyone is the chanting of the name of Godhead. This was introduced in this age by Lord Chaitanya. Bhakti Yoga actually begins with the chanting of the holy name, as confirmed by Madhvacharya in his commentary on the Mundaka Upanishad. He quotes this verse from the Narayana Sanhita. Dvapariyaya Janaya Vishnu Pantaratrai Stukevalai Kalau Tu Nama Matre Na Pujyate Bhagavan Hari. In Dwarapa Yuga, people should worship Lord Vishnu only by the regulative principles of the Narada Pancharatra and other such authorized books. In the age of Kali, however, people should simply chant the holy names of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Hare Krishna mantra is specifically mentioned in many Upanishads, such as the Kali Santarana Upanishad, where it is said, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Iti Shodashakam Nam Nam, Kali Kalmasha Nashanam, Natta Parataropaya, Sarva Vedeshu Drishyate. After searching through all the Vedic literature, one cannot find a method of religion more sublime for this age than the chanting of Hare Krishna. Tapta Hema Samakanti Prakanda Sharir Nava Mega Jini Kanta Dvani Ye Gambir. The luster of his expansive body resembles molten gold. The deep sound of his voice conquers the thundering of newly assembled clouds. Dargya Vistare Ye Apanarahata Charihasta Hoya Mahapurusha Vikyata. One who measures 4 cubits in height and in breadth by his own hand is celebrated as a great personality. Niyagroda Parimandala Hoya Tar Nam Niyagroda Parimandala Tanu Chaitanya Gunadam. Such a person is called Niyagroda Parimandala, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who personifies all good qualities, has the body of a Niyagroda Parimandala. Purport. No one other than the Supreme Lord himself, who has engaged the conditioned souls by his own illusory energy, can possess these bodily features. These features certainly indicate an incarnation of Vishnu and no one else. So, over the years, we have heard that so many people, they say this person is an incarnation of God, this person is an incarnation of God. So, we, because we follow the scriptures, we will never be fooled by some imitation God. Because we know that there are symptoms. We also know from this Chaitanya Charitamrita that Vishnu does not appear in Kali Yuga. That's why one of his names is Triyuga. He doesn't appear. So especially in Kali Yuga, when somebody says this person is God, this person is God, it's all hogwash. It's a lie. It's alternative fake news. God does appear in Kali Yuga. Prabhupada said, how does Krishna appear in Kali Yuga? As the Hare Krishna movement. Yeah. Except that one. As Prabhupada writes in the 10th canto. Because you get this question. I get it all the time. Prabhu, it says in Gita, wherever there's a discrepancy, Krishna is supposed to come. So, with Kali Yuga, it's so bad. Where is Krishna? So Prabhupada answers this. Yes, Krishna has appeared. He has taken birth in the womb of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. Krishna has appeared as the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. That's why we chant the Hare Krishna Mantra. Because it is Krishna. And we are servants of Krishna. And yes, we are meant to give Krishna to everyone. That's why we give this Hare Krishna Mantra to anyone and everyone, whether they like it or not. Because we want to give them Krishna. So here he is. He's in this Krishna consciousness movement. Ajano lambita bhuja kamala lochan tila phula jini nasa sudangshu vadana. His arms are long enough to reach his knees. His eyes are just like lotus flowers. His nose is like a sesame flower. And his face is as beautiful as the moon. Shanta danta krishna bhakti nishta parayana Bhakta Vatsala Sushila Sarave Bhutasama. He is peaceful, self-controlled, and fully devoted to the transcendental service of Lord Sri Krishna. He is affectionate toward his devotees. He is gentle and is equally disposed toward all living beings. Chandanera Angada Bala Chandana Bhushana Nitya Kali Pari Karena Krishna Sankirtan. He is decorated with sandalwood bangles and armlets and anointed with the pulp of sandalwood. He especially wears these decorations to dance in Sri Krishna Sankirtan. E Shabaguna Lai Muni Vaishampayana Sahasra Nama Kailatar Nama Ganana. Recording all these qualities of Lord Chaitanya, the sage Vaishampayana included his name in the Vishnu Sahasranam. Wow. So Lord Chaitanya is in Vishnu Sahasranam. Therefore, he must be Vishnu. He's God, but he's coming as disguised, covert operation. Our government does so many covert operations. We don't even know. But they're doing these. So they didn't get it out of the thin air. Everything comes from the absolute truth. The absolute truth also does covert operations. God comes not as God, but as his own worshiper, his own devotees. Bhakta avatar, bhakta rupa. God coming as his own devotee. Why? This will be explained in the fifth chapter. Advaita Acharya points out, and Krishnadas Kaviraj points out, that the ecstasy of being a devotee is greater than the ecstasy of being God. Let that sink in. Everybody in the material world is trying to be God. Fool! You can enjoy better than God by becoming a Hare Krishna devotee. Very nice. Dwi lila chaitanyera adi ara shesh. Dwi lilaya chari chari nama vishesh. The pastimes of Lord Chaitanya have two divisions. The early pastimes, adi lila, and the later pastimes, shesha lila. He has four names in each of these two leelas. I don't know what those eight names are. If anybody knows what those four names are in each, that would be nice research work. I would love to know what are those four names. We already knew one, Vishvambara. I could surmise, yes, he was known as Nimai Pandit, but it would be nice to know definitively what those four, eight names are. Suvarna Varno Hemango Varangas Chandadangadi Sanyatsa Krichchamo Shanto Nishta Shanti Parayana. This may be a clue. In his early pastimes, he appears as a householder with a golden complexion. His limbs are beautiful, and his body smeared with the pulp of sandalwood seems like molten gold. In his later pastimes, he accepts the sannyas order and he is equipoised and peaceful. He is the highest abode of peace and devotion, for he silences the impersonalist non-devotees. Yes, we can also silence the impersonalist non-devotees. Why? Why do we want to silence them? Because whatever they talk is nonsense. How do you silence them? Prasad. Don't talk, just eat. Just eat. This is a verse from the Mahabharata, Dana Dharma Vishnu Sahasranam Stotra. In his commentary on Vishnu Sahasranam, called the Namartha Sudha, Srila Baladeva Vijubhasan, commenting on this verse, asserts that Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Personality of Godhead according to the evidence of the Upanishads. He explains that Suvarna Varna means a golden complexion. He also quotes the Vedic injunction, Yada Pasya pasyate rukmavarnam kartaram isham purusham brahma yonam. Mukunda Upanishad. Rukmavarnam kartaram isham refers to the Supreme Personality of Godhead as having a complexion the color of molten gold. Purusham means the Supreme Lord, and Brahma Yonim indicates that he is also the Supreme Brahman. This evidence too proves that Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. Another meaning of the description of the Lord as having a golden hue is that Lord Chaitanya's personality is as fascinating as gold is attractive. Yes, in the fifth canto, we learned how the color of gold is very much attractive to a materialist. Srila Baladev Bhujubhusan has explained that the word varanga means exquisitely beautiful. Lord Chaitanya accepted sannyas, leaving aside his household life to preach his mission. He has equanimity in different senses. First, he describes the confidential truth of the personality of Godhead. And second, he satisfies everyone by knowledge and attachment to Krishna. He is peaceful because he renounces all topics not related to the service of Krishna. Sri Baladev Vidyabhushan has explained that the word nishta indicates his being rigidly fixed in chanting the holy name of Sri Krishna. Lord Chaitanya subdued all disturbing opponents of devotional service, especially the monists who are actually averse to the personal feature of the Supreme Lord. Vyakta Kari Bhagavate Kahe Bar Bar Kali Yuga Dharma Nama Sankirtan Sar. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it is repeatedly and clearly said that the essence of religion in the age of Kali is the chanting of the holy name of Krishna. Everybody, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. On time, march it to dust. Do we have any? Yes, Rabindranath. Hare Krishna. How is that possible?
You mentioned how the devotee feels more happiness than Krishna feels. I heard the example Prabhupada gave about if one's like riding a bicycle and one holds on to the car, then one's going as fast as a car. But in terms of like becoming more happier than Krishna, what's the reference for that?
The reference is as, well, first of all, it's directly stated in the Adi Lila 5. That's the first thing. Uh-huh. Okay. Number two, we see in the opening section of the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the mission statement verses, two verses about Lord Chaitanya's internal reasons for appearing. Lord Chaitanya had three reasons why he appeared, personal reasons. The external reason is to give the holy name, but he had personal, Krishna came with personal agenda. And that agenda was, Krishna looks at Radharani and realizes, wait a second, I'm the reservoir of all pleasure. I'm the absolute truth, but why is Radharani enjoying more than me? I don't understand this. So Krishna himself admits that Radharani's enjoyment is greater than his. The only way he can understand that, he has to take her position. Her position is Krishna's servant. So these are the two references. You enjoy more serving Krishna than trying to be Krishna.
Okay, so that's an actual reference in the fifth chapter. Okay.
Fifth chapter, and this explanation is,
well, I'm just thinking
coming up in the next chapter as well.
Yeah, I'm just thinking in terms of like Radharani. She's part of the internal potency. So there's, you know, difference between the internal and the marginal.
Yes, but when the marginal potency is in contact with the superior energy, it regains its normal happy position. Sound familiar?
Uh-huh.
Prabhupada's Hare Krishna address.
Yeah.
So marginal means we can fluctuate. Sometimes we're in Maya, or as Prabhupada told that one devotee, no, you're always in Maya. Sometimes you fall into Krishna. Okay? So when we're engaged in devotional service, you're enjoying. Right now, you're enjoying. Isn't it great? Keep doing devotional service and enjoy. Give up devotional service, suffer, sucker.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
He's next.
Yes, I had a question. You mentioned the four main places of the Mayavadis, and I thought it was interesting that two of them were Krishna's places, Jagannath Puri and Dwarka. And I was wondering, why that is, because they don't accept Krishna as a Supreme Lord, but yet two of their main places for their temples are Krishna's places.
That I don't know. Sorry. I'm sorry.
Yes, they don't accept him as the Supreme Lord, but they do accept him as a very highly advanced soul. In fact, if you go to the Self-Realization Fellowship, and they are Mayavadis, you will find Krishna on the altar, along with their gurus. So they do venerate him, they glorify him, but they think of him as just simply the Supreme Light is manifesting through him, you see. And when he quote unquote dies, then he enters back into the Supreme Light. But still, they see him as, in their own terms, as a great, not devotee, but as a great jnani.
Okay, last question will be Sachi Chinoy, because time is essence. Yes.
Prabhu, in that statement that you made, that Lord Krishna's incarnation in the holy name is being taken in the ISKCON movement. And if somebody will ask and say, if I am not affiliated with ISKCON and they chant the holy name in some other place, would that mean
Krishna's not there? What was that last
part? What? You know, we have that statement, that reference where it says that the incarnation of Krishna,
yes,
the holy name,
okay,
took birth in the ISKCON movement.
You said that.
So if somebody will ask you, well, I'm not affiliated, if somebody who's not affiliated with ISKCON, would that mean Krishna is not in, you know?
You'd have to ask Prabhupada. I'm not going to comment. I just repeat the words of my spiritual master. They either accept it or not. I'm not here to argue. Haribol. Amala Bhakta has the last word.
Again, coming back to my previous statement, and I was in a Mayavad Sampradaya. In fact, I was a Mayavad sannyasi. So this is from the horse's mouth. Yes, they do chant the Hare Krishna mantra, but with a totally different intention than we do. Okay, so Krishna's name can be chanted by even a parrot, but they do not have the intention that the Vaishnavas have, which is basically to serve the Lord with all our heart and soul. Their idea of the Hare Krishna mantra is, this will help me to merge into the infinite light and I will become the light and that's all. But a little later on, or a lot later on, they will fall out of the light and try to find some nice, you might call it humanitarian or philanthropic or altruistic type of activity, which will be their first step back into personalism, and hopefully it will lead to the supreme personalism, which is what we are practicing here.